wanna be the very best that no one ever was. To catch them is my real test. To train them is my cause. I will travel across the land, searching far and wide. Is Pokemon to understand the power that's inside? Pokemon, gotta catch 'em all.
Yeah, my 痛み悲しみで傷ついた君を消せないここの背負いやってこう生きることを投げ出さないで失ってしまうのかな薄れてゆく笑顔と君を守りたいから響く僕を呼ぶ声さえ枯れ溶けそうか。
Despite the idiocy of that opening skit, Bleach chapter 504 came out today, and that's what the fuck I'm gonna talk about. Before I get started, though, I just want to say that I got some spoiler stuff sent to me. Somebody sent me a message. It was probably like around 11 or so. And I was like, okay, I appreciate, you know, that you let me know that the chapter was out, which I knew, I just didn't feel like getting up. But, yeah, don't send me spoiler shit. You know, I mean, and to that person that did, I'm not even saying it was just you, but it was like more than one person sending me shit, and like I was getting shit like on the weekend saying stuff about pertaining to Naruto. Oh yeah, man, I just read something from this site that was translated from something that this site said. I was like, dude, I don't give a fuck, alright? Don't send me a spoiler. Don't that kind of ruin the fucking moment? Right? Don't that kind of ruin the moment? I mean, I would rather wait for the shit to come out and then read it than to, like, have already known what the shit is about and then fucking watching it, right? I think that's why now I don't even watch the fucking animes of these mangas that I read because I already know. So, I mean, other than to see it animated, what's the point? Oh, sex me, baby, baby. Come on. Sex me, baby. All right. I apologize for that R. Kelly song too. My girlfriend dared me to do it, so, you know, you want to get laid again, you do that type of stuff. But on to the chapter review. The chapter starts off with the Quincy activating Chojiro's Bankai. Chojiro's Bankai is actually called Kyoko Konryu Rikuyu. That's a cool sounding name, actually, though. I actually had someone to translate that shit for me, so don't be thinking, oh, no, I don't know what it means. I just actually had a voice to, like, I put it in my phone, and it tried its best to say it, and that's what it came up with. So that's what I'm going with. I'm going with the, Kyoko Konryu Rikyu, because that's how it sounded on my phone. So I'm going to go with that. And, of course, like I said before in my last chapter review, you know, it's lightning-based. We all knew that, right? You know, I mean, there was no prize won for me knowing that shit was lightning-based. It was just, you know, if you watch the filler arc, which I didn't, I didn't watch that shit. But, you know, I read some of the data books, and that was one thing that Kubo said. You know, Kubo said that his shit was based on lightning, so, you know, even his Shikai had some type of shit to do with lightning. We didn't really get to see it, but, you know, it had some shit to do with lightning, so we can only come to the fucking conclusion that his Bankai could do the same shit, right? And then after this, we're shown a shot of Yomoto looking at Sterner O. As it activates the Bankai, and to Yamamoto, it reminds him of Chojiro.
Mm-hmm.
title page, which I'm actually confused about, maybe because I'm stupid, but, you know, I don't know. Because one, it says, like, Bleach 504, before the shadows or some shit. And then, like, it cuts to the next page, and the other page at the very top is in black as well. And then that shit say Beyond the Thunders. So, is it called Before the Shadows, Beyond the Thunders, or is it just Before the Shadows? I don't really know. Like I said, I'm stupid, so I don't know. Maybe that was just something to do with the fucking lightning. I don't know, because it wasn't, like, painstakingly obvious. I thought it was connected to the last fucking page, but, you know, I'm stupid. I'll take that. I'm stupid. And then we get those typical bad guy lines from the Quincy. He's like,
oh, your fucking lieutenant hasn't used this shit in over fucking 200 years, and how nostalgic to be fucking defeated by your subordinates, Bankai. And I'm thinking to myself, dude, don't you think this guy's the fucking head captain for a reason? Aren't you fucking wondering what happened between your fucking boss and this guy 1,000 years ago? Don't you wonder that, Quincy? What the fuck made you think his fucking lieutenant, yeah, you said it, his subordinate, what made you think that was going to do something to him? Don't understand, Quincy. I never understand that shit with bad guys. I never understand that shit. You know, why the fuck do you think some type of way that whatever, I mean, this motherfucker is a head captain for a reason, all right? It's not because, oh, well, he's the oldest, let's just give him the fucking position because he's old and he's going to die in like the next 5 minutes, so, you know, it's not. No, he's strong, okay? He's the strongest motherfucker there possibly. No, ain't a possibly, fuck it. I'm just going to say that he's the strongest fighter there. So what the hell made you think, as Stern Ritter O, who, like I said, I don't give a, even if it's from fucking A to Z, with A being the highest and Z being the lowest, or from Z to A with Z being the highest and A being the lowest, goddammit, even then, even still, as O, you are in like that center part. I don't give a fuck if you killed 1,000 Shinigami before you got there. I don't give a fuck if you killed 1,000,000 before you got there. You're not fucking with this guy. Because it's obvious from reading these chapters that the fucking Bankai is not handled in the same regard by these Quincy's as it is by the Shinigami. It seems that the Bankai loses, like, some of its power, I'm assuming, because it's not handled by the correct user. But as soon as I read that panel, I was just like, fuck, man, here we go again with these dumbass bad guys saying all this stupid shit. So, yeah, I kind of got annoyed. And then the Quincy proceeds to strike Yamamoto with the fucking lightning. You know, he just has it at his beck and call, and he's just fucking striking him down with that shit. You know, and Shuhei is just like, damn, I haven't, you know, seen a Bankai that can manipulate fucking weather and shit since so Shiro's Bankai. I tried to say the name, but I always get tongue-tied saying that shit. But, yeah, Shuhei is kind of astounded by Chojiro's Bankai. And I'm wondering, is he astounded by that shit because he hasn't seen it, or because they have the same rank? Technically, they're both lieutenants. But it's obvious that Chojiro's power was on a level that was totally different from what Shuhei has. I honestly believe that if Shuhei was to embrace the demon inside of him, that he would be like a fucking Kenpachi type ass character. But because of Kaname's bitch ass teachings and shit, he's gonna never embrace the demon inside of him, which pisses me off, which further delays his fucking Bankai, which he should have by now. And actually, he should have been the fucking, I'm sorry, let's continue with the chapter. And then the next panel cuts, you can kinda almost tell right away that it's a fucking flashback because of the shit that was said. Edgy side, don't know.
Just like, who the fuck is Edgyside? And who would be talking during the moment in time other than the bad guy? And he wasn't saying no Edgyside. So you know that it cuts to a flashback, and lo and behold, we get this fucking clip. I'm not gonna lie, when I saw that picture of Yamamoto, I was kind of weirded the fuck out, because I don't know why, but it was something like, as soon as I saw that motherfucker, I knew
that it was Yamamoto, but at the same time, I was thinking, like, that motherfucker looked like Mario. Like, after Mario fucking retired from saving Peach and Plumber and shit, he gonna look like that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not used to it. As soon as I saw it, I was like, what the fuck? I knew that it was the head captain, but just him looking young and shit, and I'm just kind of like, what the fuck is that? You know what I'm saying? I just kind of like, what the hell is that? Not to say that the drawing was bad, you know what I'm saying? I knew it was him, but I just wasn't expecting to see him, because he still looked kind of old then. You know what I'm saying? He kind of looked like how Hachi did in the first Tekken game and shit. And I just kind of like, damn, I just never fucking imagined seeing Yamamoto as a younger old man, if that makes sense. You know, he just, I don't know, he just seemed like always old and shit. That's almost like when we saw Byakuya young in the Turn Back the Pendulum thing. I wasn't expecting that, because he just seemed like he was such a fucking always grown up character, that to see him as a child and shit, you know, still kind of being like a pig headed type motherfucker, I'm like, wow, I wasn't expecting that.
And then the next few panels proceed to show like the history between Yamamoto and Chojiro, and it was pretty much like Chojiro was like, I'm gonna be your right hand. And then Yamamoto was like, well, you can just become another one of my disciples. He was like, nah, I'm not going to be a disciple. I'm not going to be a copy of you. I'm going to be, you know, pretty much your fucking, I'm going to be your right hand. Fuck it. I mean, what more of an explanation do you need than whatever the fuck you can't do, I'm going to be able to help you out with. So that's what Chojiro wanted with his life. I don't know why. You know, I don't know why. I mean, I know it's going to sound crazy, but what did Yamamoto do in his past, like in that part of his life, to where he was already known as a badass? You know what I mean? So I'm like, what the fuck did he do in his past? I don't know. That's kind of, because I'm assuming then he was already famous and shit, and yeah, because he looked younger right there. So I'm trying to figure out, was he fucking, you know, I'm assuming this was probably like around 300 years ago, maybe, or something like that. 200 or 300 years ago. You know, and he fought that Quincy guy 1,000 years ago. You know, so I'm thinking, yeah, I wonder, like, what did he do to become, like, the shit? That's weird. Anyway, yeah, it shows a history between those two. And, the panel that I found interesting was that, Chojiro was like, yeah, I mastered my Bankai. And then Yamamoto was like, how tough is this fucking old man if he can get struck by lightning and walk away with a scar that intersects his previous scar? That's a gangster motherfucker. To walk away from lightning and all you got is a cut on your forehead, man. I mean, your fucking hairs aren't even singed on your face. Your mustache still looks healthy. Your fucking ponytail hair thing in the back still looks healthy. Your fucking sides are still slicked down. I mean, this is a strong motherfucking opponent for no reason. And then old man Yamamoto goes on to say that he told Chojiro that, you know, your Bankai is like that of a child. And even though it didn't defeat me, you did put a scratch on my head. And Chojiro was like, yeah, I completely agree with you. My shit is immature right now. But I'm going to train so that, you know, it won't be this way anymore. I'm gonna train real, real hard so that I can be able to help you. And that's what the fuck he did, apparently. Apparently, he was able to, you know, fucking get his Bankai to, like, the strongest level, apparently, that it could become. And now I'm actually fucking regretful and sad and shit that this guy has passed away. Never thought I would say that about Chojiro, but I actually am sad that he's gone now. And this Quincy is still just fucking striking him with his lightning, and the Quincy's like, oh, what, you don't have, you know, the fucking will to attack me because I'm using your subordinate Bankai, which is stupid again, because just because you got this Bankai, it's not like you holding this motherfucker hostage and shit. You like, use your fucking Bankai. He's like, sorry, Captain.
strike lightning. You're not doing that, alright? He's fucking dead, alright? If anything, Yamamoto would really want to destroy you in the fucking slowest way possible so that you could feel every ounce of fucking pain that he has felt by losing his lieutenant. Just because you got his Bankai doesn't mean shit. It wouldn't mean shit to me. I mean, that's almost like if somebody killed my dad. Hold on for one second. Hello? What's up? Hey. 4,000? What's the average? Oh, dang. So we gonna triple that one. Recording the video right now as we speak. And you in it. And I never stopped recording it when you called because I was like in the middle of talking about something. I was just like, hold on.
You on speakerphone?
Yeah. I apologize for that, and I don't even remember what I was talking about, so let me just start over. As Yamamoto is continuously getting struck by this lightning or whatever, he's got like an inner dialogue going, and he's like, Chojiro, it must be like unbearable or some shit, you know, for you to just have to see that your Bankai ... then we get this shot. Proceeds to do what I'm nominating as the top number one fucking sword slash of all fucking times. I'm throwing in shit from Rurouni Kenshin, Seven Samurai, Samurai X, fucking Jubi-chan. I'm throwing in all of Zoro's fights. This, by far, I don't give a fuck you argue with me or not. This, by far, was the best single sword slash I have ever had the pleasure of fucking reading. Hands down. Check it out. Well, I really do have to say that that sound bite was fucking totally random, but what is? And that's how the chapter ends there, man. What do you guys expect from chapter 505? do you think it's going to be revealed who the fucking sword person was that had the ship pointed towards Ulahata? Think Ichigo is going to break out? Think he's going to get holified? You think they're going to cut back to Byakuya for some fucking reason? I don't know. You think the Zero Squad is going to ever show up since they were fucking hyped? Everyone's been talking about them. Do you think they're going to show up? I don't think so. Not yet. Anyway, I think this is just the beginning of this fucking war. You know, so we'll have to see. Do you think all this fucking thousand Shinigami that have fucking died are actually dead? You know, I hope so, because reading Naruto, that really hasn't been a war. It's been more like, I don't know what. There's no word to describe that, because I've never seen a fight where no one got injured. So. That's all for me, man. You can give me a thumbs up. That'd be fucking awesome. Leave some comments on the thing below. And, yeah. I will see you bad boys next Wednesday.